In the criminal justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
What are they?
Smart watchers. A lot of them in this part of the park.
Boring.
You get to sit down.
Grandpa, that's no fun. This is. Hold on, Grandpa.
No, you don't want you going off the path by yourself.
Grabbed from this side. Probably off that bench. discussion today.
So how long this evening?
You better listen to these guys and feathers. Easier than I do.
Class in uptown field before they buy a
deal. I'll fix her up.
Okay, thanks.
Why are you good?
I love you.
Hotel by check for Liberty.
Fritz Wright was at the property 4 p.m. yesterday. Is he in some kind of trouble?
Is stealing money that's a crime?
Once I got him, the Liberty rapist.
Well, you got him when he was a little ranger.
How can we hurt him? They called forensics. They never matched the pubic hairs found on Liberty.
In fact, that he once I gave
him. So, his DNA and his hair showed up on a prior record.
Bingo.
Where is he now?
What the Canada is looking for.
I'm not straight, Cassie. While Dudley Do-Right's out searching the 10 provinces, it's about 4 million square miles. The soul could have come back into this country without the show.
He's still a suspect.
Yeah, go ahead. Much rain on my parade.
I don't just want to rain on your parade. I want to flood all the flows.
Where are we going?
Lower East Side. I spoke to Ken 9 years. He and his son of mine works at a donut shop there. Yeah, Ken Maggio working for you.
Maggio? Well, the crook. What's minimum wage?
He's big in the back. The same thing?
That's in town.
I'm not sure if that's a yes.
Police looking for Ken Maggio? He committed sodomy? You're trying to ruin my rep?
You beat it to that one. It doesn't look like you're going to be getting that
pastry chef job at Boulay Bakery.
Oh, would you look at this? What a cliche.
He's shaking his head trying to make himself look different.
Or he just makes himself look more and more ugly.
What's next, huh? Fake glasses? Fake nose?
Does this turn you on?
What do you want?
Isn't it a little dangerous when you be around all these helpless donuts?
Come on, what do you want? Your alibi yesterday, 3 p.m., 5 p.m.
Oh, I was hungry.
You're not lying, Josiah, because that would be bad. Very bad.
You better talk to us, because we're looking at you for rape homicide right now.
That's true.
Bet you prosecuted me.
Hey, you can't pin that one on me. I was with my lover.
A guy named Frank Stern. Lives on James Street.
So you went over to the dark side, the love that dare not speak its name. How convenient. Too gay to rape a DA, huh?
You wanna know why?
I'll show you why, huh?
Here.
See? They gave me a walking bath at Elmira.
Soaked in sulfuric acid. I can't even make a freaking ant.
Guys, check this out.
Teddy Kennedy lands in the water at Chaffin by July 8th.
Neil Armstrong lands on the moon July 20th. Think about that.
And?
You don't find that amazing?
Nope.
You're learning, Jeffers.
Hey, Mark, what's up with your donut store guy?
Well, let's put it this way. The guy will never be accused of a crime involving penile penetration. Wanna know why?
Yeah, why?
Pass it on the scrub?
So does anybody look good for Labor Day?
Yeah.
Cassidy helped forensics nail a guy named Jean Dussault, who was deported to Canada, but Kennedy can't find him, sir. They got the dog sleds out looking for him now.
Well, keep on him, because Dussault's Labor Day M.O. is very similar to the Fitzgerald ring, okay?
Now, you're a guy. What's his name?
Richard White.
Yeah, him. Where does he sit in?
Neil's alibi looks good for Fitzgerald, but I went through the White trial transcript.
Fitzgerald lets him play down midway through the trial,
but not before just dragging his ass through the one he had to lead in.
All right. John, I want you to talk to the date rape victim, Louise Billings.
And Jeffrey's got a hold of Fitzgerald's best friend and attorney.
Joan Simon. She's coming in this afternoon.
All right. Well, you should get some background there, too.
Let's get him.
Richard could be a really sweet man. But sometimes he'd get abusive. He'd push me around. Make me do things sexually that I really didn't want to do.
Like Mr. Jekyll and Dr. Hyde.
I started losing weight from the tension. I couldn't sleep. Broke it off after 3 years.
How did he react to that?
He was calm. He said he understood.
And how did he react to that?
I kept on bumping into him. We'd make a little small talk and then he'd move on. It was more like talking to an old friend rather than a lover.
How often did you run into him?
I don't know. 2-3 times a month.
Didn't you think all these meetings were odd in a city this size or accidentally cross paths how often?
My shrink says it was a classic case of cognitive dissonance. So, we ran into each other again. Richard was in a particularly charming mood. I invited him up to my place for dinner. For old time's sake.
He got drunk.
And then I was looking at Mr. Hyde. He grabbed me and threw me down. And he told me to call to him and beg for forgiveness. don't teach you self-defense in the New York law books.
Did she ever say she was afraid of anyone?
Never. She was fearless. Not trusting, not naive. Fearless. We'd go out to eat and guys would hit on us. She'd flash her ADA's ID badge at them and they'd disappear. Can you think of any incident, regardless of whether or not you think it's relevant? About a month ago, we were having lunch, and there was a guy sitting across from us. He was smiling, staring. I pointed him out to Karen, and she got rattled. Instead of doing her ID thing, she said that we should leave.
She said why?
No. I asked her about it a few weeks later, and she still said nothing.
Do you see him on this page?
That's him.
Boyd sends flowers to one vic, smiles at another vic in a restaurant. They get rattled. What's your point?
He's stalking her.
Impossible. We don't have a stalking statute in New York. Ergo, there's no way to stalk anyone.
An assistant DA's murder. Maybe he'll change the statute.
I got White's trial transcript from Jeffries. His partner Phillips was a character witness. He has to corroborate his alibi for the Fitzgerald rape.
Well, she might be the weak link.
If you were clean, why would you stay partners with garbage like White?
Maybe she's afraid?
Maybe. See if that's what she says.
Phillips!
Is this the house Mr. White was at 4 p.m. Thursday?
Yeah, it's all in the broker's report.
I'm sorry, Fatty.
It's all in the broker's report. But here, I'll show you. When I get the key, it makes a record of my visit.
So now all your information is being sent to group properties?
That's how it works. How well do you know Richard White? Well enough. He's my business partner, after all. For how long? 2 years? I met Richard when we were at an open house. He proposed that we start our own company and said that he'd provide seed money.
Just like that?
Well, we've been talking about the big realty companies eating up our commissions. And
so you basically went into business with a complete stranger?
Actually, I said no. I thought he was a little odd. Kind of blew him off initially.
What turned you around?
He did a really sweet thing. He sent me flowers with a card that said his feelings weren't hurt or something like that.
He's persistent.
That's what it takes in real estate. We kept running into each other at these open houses, and he pitched the idea to me. After a while, it started sounding good, so I said, why not?
And you've done well together.
Yeah, very. I have a closing in about a half an hour. Does that answer your questions?
Yeah. If we need anything else, we'll just give you a call.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Yeah.
She held it out here, though, too. So tell me
why. White's a suspect in a rape homicide investigation?
I would be afraid to talk about him, too, if I were her.
Biggest threat in the
world. She could always come to us. Why cover for the man?
Why did Louise Billings let him into her apartment? He controls. Somehow, he controls.
I know you fixed that, White, but listen, I'd forget Dussault's fellow question.
Lunch, Cassidy, and Canada are dealing with Dussault. We're hanging on to White until we have a reason not to.
Fine. Assuming White's our guy, you think Phillips knows what he did?
No. But I think that he's got something on her.
Enough to make her do what he asks.
You check with your priors?
No.
Zero.
I understand this guy, Don. He hates women who take control. He always finds some way of getting it back. Louise Billings took control by breaking it off with him. I raped her to control her. It's the same thing with Fitzgerald. She took control by prosecuting him, disparaging his reputation in the courtroom. We know what he did to get control back from her.
So, bring him in and talk to him.
What if he won't come in voluntarily?
Well, it sounds to me like he would enjoy taking you on, but if he won't come nicely, I'll bootstrap a warrant for a parole violation.
What was it like before you became a detective?
What was what like?
I mean, did you wear a uniform?
You're still wearing one now, although...
Oh, come on now. We're not here to talk about me.
I get it. Enough about me. What do you think about me?
Well, for openers, your alibi for Fitzgerald is shredding.
Oh?
Yeah, the lockbox. It seems that
but you're very attractive.
Ah, is it some of your famous charm, White?
Richard.
It's Detective Benson.
I know. A year and a half in the special victims unit. Graduate of Siena College. It's public record. You can find almost anything if you know where to look.
You know who you are?
A realer.
You're a nosy porker.
And you're a bitch.
Did I hit a nerve?
I don't have any nerves. How about you?
We'll see.
I got a quaint turn of the century rat hole to show. Unless you've got some evidence of me.
Go with God, Richard.
Use his beeper to open that lockbox that day, didn't he?
place.
So I went to my front door and I looked through the people.
What'd you see?
Stucky guy, 40s maybe, headed for the stairs.
You saw his face?
Yeah. He turned and looked directly at my door, like he could see right through it.
That's him.
Only what?
Well, he don't look so nuts in the picture.
wants me.
Where?
Somewhere you feel safe.
The station house.
Funny. Make it the Ramble. A bench that brings back fond memories. You know the one. 7 a.m.
Don't be late.
Olivia, I'm not a fool. If I see one cop, we'll never consummate our relationship.
You look disappointed, Olivia. What's the matter?
Can't I get to
Just tell me once more. How'd you kill her?
Thrill seeker. No. I'm through. Do what you can with what you got. I don't think you can kill me with it. Pity. I'm fixed on you. Until I'm dead, I'll always be in your head. Just like your mother has somebody in her head. We're joined at the hip now, aren't we? Detective Stabler.
How are Kathy and the kids?
Justice system. Sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
I've just been raped.
Thank you.
nail swabbing, fingernails. You combed her pubic hair, took vaginal swabs, and did blood work. I'll bag this, and we need to do a UV on her stomach.
What?
We need to do a UV light, check for semen, obviously.
We don't have one.
It's a small box. It's about 8x2. Looks like a hardback book with a cover.
No, I know what it is, and we don't have it in this facility.
Just forget it. I made her take a shower anyway.
This is overall. It will, as we discussed, prevent pregnancy. Please.
I know. I know.
You need to take 2 more in 12 hours. We'll have your STD and AIDS test results back within 24 hours. You need to retest at the 3 and 6 month marks.
Who's paying for all this? The state is. What else? I'm gonna need to get a formal statement from you. But if you're too tired now and you want to go back to your apartment first.
I just want this to be over with.
Okay, I can take you down to the station right now if you're ready.
Ready.
What'd you find?
No real sign of trauma. Wound replacement with much worse.
The guy used the least amount of force possible. Ejaculated on her stomach and made her kind of shallow, so aren't there any chances?
Slim. Is that you?
Did you guys hear about the stranger? Right?
Too hot. It was. So just till it was just right. And then he gently took off my gown so I could see to get in. And he washed me. Told me I had pretty hair. He touched my stomach. He touched everything. He handed me a towel. He handed me the robe. He told me to get on the floor and look away. Count to 20. He said he wasn't going to insult me. I asked him not to call the police. Vaughn follows me. Do you live with your boyfriend?
No.
Is he keys to your place?
No, but I have keys to his.
Can you tell us about the gun the guy was carrying?
I didn't see it, but he held it to my head when he caught me looking at him in the shower.
What do you look like?
Tall, thin, white, sandy hair.
Tell me about his eyes.
How tall? I don't know. Tallish.
How old do you think he was?
Around my age, I guess. Like, someone I would know, someone I'd hang out with.
Did you know?
No.
Anything unusual happened in the last few days that suggests something like this might happen? Strangers around the neighborhood? Odd phone calls?
No.
Was he nervous?
He wasn't nervous.
What did he smell like?
He was wearing cologne. Subtle, not cheap.
Could you identify him in the lineup?
Absolutely.
He took your ring. Could you describe that for us, please?
It's very rare. What? It is a small branch with diamond leaves curling over the band. It was my grandmother's.
Did he take anything else with him?
My wallet was on the dresser next to my jewelry box.
You said that he wiped your stomach with a t-shirt. Did he leave that behind?
No. He must have taken it from the drawer before. My Rosie, the riveter. You know, the girl flexing her bicep. We can do it. Near the restaurant where I wait tables.
What laundromat do you use?
Can I get you anything? No. Okay, we are done.
We can drive you to a friend's or if you have family or friends.
No.
I thought I'd call him in.
Find any prints?
No.
see if there's two types of DNA.
At this point, he immobilizes her, takes her ring, and rapes her.
We still haven't found the underwear that she was wearing.
Ricky did that too?
Truth is.
Maybe. Then he takes her to the top.
6, long blonde hair.
No, sorry, no, I don't know her.
into it.
No, you just described it just now.
Last night, were you watching her?
Well, last night, no.
So you're tired of watching?
Did you stroll across the street?
Oh, wait. I was here. I saw everything. What did you think? Don't I need a lawyer?
Look at being a peeping Tom, not just being a trick.
What'd you see?
I saw this guy climb the fire escape. The previous tenant had broken the lock on the window. She was laying there asleep. And she woke up. And he pulled the gown up over her eyes. She
what?
She doesn't wear underwear when she sleeps. He raped her on the bed. And he took her to the bathroom.
Why didn't you call police?
Then what?
I couldn't see.
What'd he look like?
I really couldn't see him.
You can see a broken lock, you can see a nightgown, but you can't see the rapist's face.
I wasn't looking at him. Not at him. What are you gonna do to me?
The same thing you did for her. Hey, I've been cross-checking her for CSAAT. You know, looking for victims who used her hair salon and grocery store and dry cleaners. Victims in each place, but none of their attackers had similar signatures.
You think Harper is the kind of woman that would buy $500 worth of hand-packed meats?
Not even if it was on sale.
Someone used their credit card. Munch and Cassidy are bringing the suspect over from the 27.
Ryan
big deal. This is the last night. A guy who looks an awful lot like you.
first floor.
I jumped the turnstile getting on a 1-9.
What time did you get out?
Like 1 a.m. Where'd you get a credit card? I found a wallet in a garbage can corner on Moore Street. Been picked clean of cash. Look, I took that wallet, but I never, never raped anyone.
Mr. Raymond's not you.
What time did you get that printer?
Around 5:30, Mike.
Because they update the records every day.
At 6 p.m. Thank you. ejaculate on your stomach?
Yes.
He made me take a shower. I told the police that I just got out of the shower when I found him. Why was it the rape in your police report? That or the watch? The police were touching everything and looking for fingerprints. I wanted them gone. It was so embarrassing. He kept saying, "Isn't this how you like it?" when he was pushing inside of me. I bought that gun for self-protection and I didn't even. Jane, you did the one thing you're supposed to do when somebody threatens you. Survive.
Sleep at night, every single light had to be on, which meant I couldn't sleep. My boss is totally getting on my case.
sex again. A few months ago, she broke up. I know where she went. New job, new place.
Obviously not fine.
Who are you to tell me that I'm not fine?
back to normal? Then tell me, when was the last time you slept in your bed without wearing running shoes? The truth is, everybody changes every day. And some things are more devastating than others. But we never are the same. And there are two ways to deal with these changes. You either accept them, or you fight them like hell all the way. Now please, come with us back to the station and just take a look at this guy. It's going to help you more than you know. I don't want any more help. Then come back with us for us.
Justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
Yeah.
specifically here.
Ryan Davies, 8. A couple of kids played touch football and found his body in the woods behind the playing field.
From the waist down, signs of sexual assault.
Signature marks around his neck, bruises covered his body.
No signs of a struggle, no weapon, no evidence was found at the scene. Only a shot heard.
The marshes behind the field are pretty expensive. The crime most likely happened there.
We'll keep uniforms walking the marshes looking for evidence. His parents reported missing 40 hours before the body was found.
Time of death, Friday night, approximately 5 p.m. Any idea what caused the bruises?
Yeah, a hand.
The marks were round and varied from half inch to 3 inches in diameter.
Parents have a history of abuse.
Babysitter, uncle.
Teachers, coaches.
I'll check out the adults in his line. Search the neighborhood for registered sex offenders.
Any recent abductions in the neighborhood?
Not that we know of.
Kid's body was transported from A to B, left in a shallow grave.
Transporting the body, leaving it exposed. Hallmarks of a stranger.
Last time the parents saw him was after school. He went to a comic book shelf in search of Pokemon cards.
He never made it there.
He lets me get here on that alone.
Hey, you watch home 24 hours a day, you wind up with sequel neurotics.
Well, let's canvas the neighborhood, right?
To and from work?
Absolutely. It's better for the environment.
Imagine the air in this city if people rode their bikes everywhere. I've got a great old bike. A classic cruiser. I keep it covered up down back. I think someone must be jealous of it. It's been moved, the chain stolen, you name it.
It's a tough city.
It is. But we're investigating the murder of a young boy. His body was found at the playing field.
Sex offender among them, he becomes a target.
So it's it's the rights of a community versus the rights of an individual.
The fact is, anyone with an internet connection can go to a sex offender's website and find out more than he wants to know about Turbin.
He was a simple, religious man. He responded well to therapy. He had, in my opinion, a genuine turnaround.
1 year out, he molests another kid, only this one dies. This is your idea of a turnaround.
Doesn't sound at all like the Bill Turbin I knew.
Excuse me, you knew him in prison.
Come on, there's no bed check when you have to prepare your own meals, you act differently. Turbin showed genuine remorse for his crime. Couldn't sleep.
And his victim couldn't walk for a month. That boy was in the hospital on his stomach for 4 weeks.
And the night it happened, Bill was high. It's not really the right word. He was overloaded on a psychedelic STP cocktail. He was psychotic. The last thing he remembers is a boy knocking at his door selling candy bars.
So, the neighbors heard screams, they called the police.
They found the boy lying across the room unconscious. They found Bill, balled up in terror because he thought the boy was after him. He believed the boy had died and that his corpse was attacking him. It wasn't the boy's screams the neighbors heard. It was Turbin's.
I just started on the case. I wanted to show you something.
Ligature marks around the neck have an unusual pattern. Indentations about an inch apart.
What scale are these photos?
They're life size. Jane?
Thank you.
detective still have two eyewitnesses that placed Turbitt at the field at Ryan's time of death.
Two teenagers versus retired cop?
We're gonna release him.
The bike chain we found in Turbitt's house exactly matches the ligature marks on Ryan's neck, which means very little without the DNA results.
You know sex offenders have an 80% recidivism rate.
And I have an obligation to inform his counsel.
Yeah, you do. But you don't have a time constraint on that.
That was your boss.
He wants me down there right now, so don't do anything just yet, huh?
Thanks for coming down, Don. You want coffee or something?
No, I'm good. A little confused, but other than that,
tell me about it.
Used to be you catch them, we cook them. Now the law has changed with the seasons. We're not just prosecutors, we have to be politicians, too. Schiff asked me to talk to you. We need you to hold the child molester, Turbitt.
Well, if your people have any new evidence, I'd be glad to.
The monster awaits. It's not enough the neighbors weren't informed. Now we're letting him go.
Well, I share their pain, Morris, but Mr. Turbitt's alibi checked out. So I believe that means that legally he's a free man.
Poster boy for the Lock Up All the Perverts movement. The outraged citizens could care less about civil liberties when their kids are at risk.
Personally, I don't disagree with that, but I don't understand how this is my problem.
It's not. It's mine. Right now, there's a rider to a mental health bill in Albany that would give the state extremely wide latitude in keeping sex offenders off the street.
By holding them indefinitely, you've got to be kidding.
At the time of their release, you get a psychiatrist to convince the parole board the offender can't control his impulses, that he's likely to rape again. He gets sent away to Creedmoor for the rest of his life.
How can a man be found sane enough to stand trial, be convicted and do his time, and then upon release be found insane and locked up again?
It's called civil commitment.
And they need a test case.
Well, like you said, Counselor,
I only catch him. At last I heard the rule of law was you do the crime, you do the time. Mr. Turbitt did his. Why don't I just release him with a giant M on his back?
We'll work as fast as we can. I have already contacted Dr. Greenblatt, our psychologist. As a mitzvah, can you buy me some time?
This goes against everything I believe, Morris.
I know. Please.
You got 24 hours, not a minute more.
When are you coming to talk to my class?
I don't know. Around.
Oh. I gave you like a permanent branding for show and tell.
Yeah, hold on.
Okay, is that a final stay?
Where did you get that from?
Danny Baker. He says you spend your time hunting for pedophiles.
And what did you tell Danny Baker?
I told him to hear a cop. But you can tell him yourself.
days gone by. The thought of that boy doesn't go through my head. But I don't remember a single minute of it. It's like watching a whole movie. You don't remember the birthday itself, but you see the movie often enough and it becomes the memory. You know what I mean?
There are two Billys involved in this.
I don't know what scared me more. What had been done to the boy. Or that the person who had done it was me. I just had no idea I was capable of doing that.
Check your ID, we mean reading. Don't be afraid, demand that they show it.
psychiatrist who's done extensive work at the Avenal Correctional Facility in New Jersey. Is that correct?
Yes.
Can you describe Avenal for us, please?
It's a maximum security prison for violent sex offenders.
And during Mr. Turbitt's 12-year incarceration at Avenal, did he ever attack a fellow inmate sexually?
Not to my knowledge.
A guard, a psychiatrist.
No.
This is because of this one crime for which my client paid his debt to society.
And which, to an extreme degree of likelihood, he will repeat.
In your opinion? In fact, Doctor, isn't this whole legislation nothing but a cheesy end run around a cherished legal concept of double jeopardy?
Not in my opinion.
Oh, come on, Dr. Greenblatt. He was sane enough when he was convicted and served his sentence. Isn't it pretty damn convenient that he'd be declared insane now so you can put him away again? And that's just plain unconstitutional.
Miss Kreutzer, we take your point.
Thank you, Judge.
In fact, I need time to review the proposed statute. We'll be convened tomorrow. Until then, Mr. Turbitt, you're a free man.
In Ryan's neighborhood alone, there were 9 sex offenders.
You don't have children, you don't understand.
You don't have to have children to understand double jeopardy.
You guys like to reclaim on your suicide?
You want to lock them all up?
Yeah, I do.
Where does it stop?
In principle, not in practice.
Especially when you shoot the wrong eye.
Look, in the eyes of Mr. Davies, we failed.
It doesn't justify his actions.
I agree, but I understand the impulse that all of us here do. A loved one gets hurt, a child, a mother. We want to make it right.
What happened to the guy's death glass?
So let's give the money to the crime victims board.
Where the hell are we with this?
Back to square one.
Two eyewitnesses.
much.
Justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
Give me a break.
Oh, what is that, like, no means no or something?
Yes, it's exactly what it is. Come on.
Oh, come on. I didn't did your calculus homework for you.
So? Adam, seriously, no.
Oh my god.
What?
Ready to go?
Yeah, Jeffrey's, you're important.
Yeah, the Silverhead guy.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We'll stick it to him.
Well, as an administrator, I never actually met her, but she was with me.
Well, that's great that you love her, but we need to talk to people that know her.
The university will be mounting its own investigation into the tragedy, and a full report shall be sent you as soon as it's available.
Well, I'm sure that'll be very effective, Father. We know the victim was extremely drunk.
Seminars will be part of my recommendation.
That's not the point. Who was there?
Well, you should talk to the hostess committee. They planned it.
Hostess committee?
It's a sort of women's auxiliary to help support the basketball team. Very motivated campus women pitch in when necessary.
The hostesses have been a St. Raymond's institution for 50 years. They provide tutoring, logistical support, even ironing the players' shirts if needed.
We're throwing one hell of a party for the team.
They work hard. They need relaxation, too.
What was Jean Gallagher's role?
She was one of our star hostesses.
That's what Father McCourt said, too.
Who was at this party?
Players, prospective players, coaches, hostesses, and important alumni.
Did you see Jean that night?
Of course. She came early and helped set up.
Did you notice what time she left?
I left before the party was over. Perhaps your roommate, Shelley Brown, might know more than I.
Now make yourself at home.
Riley, these are detectives.
Munch and Cassidy. Have you been to the party last night?
Sure, of course.
What? You weren't drinking, were you?
What do you care?
We got kind of a reputation there, Riley. You're as well known for slamming back the bruises you are for slamming down boots.
Well, so it's off-season. It doesn't affect me on the court. And drug test doesn't test for beer consumption. Doesn't.
Cooker.
You don't know anything about me.
I know that you're an elbow thrower, the Billy and Deer move, but you don't have supposed to moves.
Look at St. Raymond's recommend before you start taking pot shots at me, okay?
You see Jean last night?
Yeah, she was at the party.
Time did she leave?
Oh, no, me and some friends split early.
Some friends and I?
Whatever. We went to this alumni dude's house and he introduced us to the mayor.
Yeah, we'll be sure to ask him about that. An alumni is plural. College man.
Anyone have a grudge with Jean?
Yeah, maybe.
Chuck Mosley was yelling at her.
Riley, you're talking about a teammate.
We're not asking you. What were they arguing about?
I didn't hear exactly, but ask anyone. She was crying, he was all yelling. You know the way those people get.
The way what people get?
You know, straight players. Don't you mess with my homies and all that gangster rap crap. Thinking they can get away with anything because they're so bad.
As opposed to suburban white boys who think they can get away with anything because of their daddy's money. Yeah? You know where we can find this Chuck Mosley?
He's got a regular run at Fifth Avenue and 100 something street.
You know, you just look for dealers and graffiti.
He'll be there.
Thank you.
drinking, start getting yourself in trouble.
That's an argument. That's an opinion. An argument is when two people yell at each other.
I wanted to leave, and I wanted her to come with me for all good.
Did she? No.
I gave her what for, and I got out.
What time, Chuck?
1:30. Conan O'Brien was on when I got home. My mom was up waiting for me.
Your mom's your alibi? That's beautiful. What's your mom's number?
I'm sick in Louisiana, so I went down to visit.
Which hospital, Chuck?
I don't know.
When's she coming back?
I don't know.
Wrong answer.
She's on a bus!
Mosey's on Icetail's alibi sticks. Kluger is a bigger bump off the court than he is on. Unfortunately, he has an alibi. He was on his way to get this second party with the mayor.
Mayor?
Yeah, I spoke to his honor this morning. He answered his own phone.
Less reassuring?
Woke him up, as a matter of fact.
What did you get from Mosey?
Mosey wasn't giving him anything either, but he did admit to an argument with the thing.
Alibi?
He was watching late night television with his mother. She is conveniently on a bus trip to Louisiana.
You get the sense the great St. Raymond University machine is throwing itself in front of this investigation?
Why would they do that? Gene Gallagher's a student there. Money.
And they got a winning franchise. Our main suspects are basketball players. What do we want to do? There's their players.
They're on $40
million. $40
million? I keep getting fundraising letters saying that they're broke.
Well, $8 million in television fees alone. Then they get more money from alumni contributions, and there's tickets and the merchandising.
Hats, t-shirts.
Plastic pen holders, plastic saints. Remember when it was all Georgetown this way is that? Now it's the UConn Huskies.
Say this. I bet St. Raymond's would love a piece of that.
Well, you may want to remind them that whatever privileges they may extend to their players, we make arrests without first considering the suspect's free throw percentages.
Not that. We end up picking roll with the administration today.
I want to talk to the roommate, who presumably doesn't have a percentage of St. Raymond's television rights. What else do you get? Tickets, cars, trips to all out-of-town games, you name it.
Awful lot of perks for just cheerleading.
It's even getting the party line. Do you think I would have quit if that's all it was? Well, what do they expect from me? The competition to recruit top players from high schools is fierce. NCAA's been cracking down on some of the more obvious money incentives. Tickets, cars, the likes, and the hostesses offer hospitality. The university never explicitly demands that you show players a good time.
And if you don't, you don't get the goodies.
Yes. I quit. Gene needed the money and the scholarship. What else can you tell us about Gene? We were close. She stuck by me, even though I quit the hostess crap. She let me go on living here with her. Does she have a boyfriend? Brother. It's not really allowed. One of the unwritten rules, hostesses must always be available.
So, what was the state of mind last week or so?
Drunk. Was Gene always a heavy drinker? No, that's what's so weird. At one point, she never drank, but then when did she start drinking? Right after the game where we got into the Sweet 16, there were like 3 days of celebrations. After that, she kind of lost her spark. That's when she started drinking.
What happened to her?
I don't know. I just know that's when she changed. Her parents might know. She moved in with them for a couple weeks after that.
Jean's roommate said she changed sometime around the end of the basketball season.
Shelly said she'd gone from being carefree to a kind of depression, drinking a lot.
You know what she changed? Stress.
Mrs. Gallagher, we need to know. Girl was raped. That's what happened to her. Doctor-patient confidentiality is the cornerstone of my practice. The students need to know they can trust me. Doctor, I hear what you're saying, but this is a rape-homicide investigation.
Doctor, telling us about your conversations with Gene is the best thing you can do for her right now.
I don't know who raped you. She never told me.
Well, did she know her attacker, or was it a stranger?
She said it was a basketball player. She didn't tell me which one. Did she give any specifics? She never identified it by name. Did she say if he was black or white? I don't know. Look, she was consciously vague, and I didn't like to push her. Dr. Goodall, he breathing heavily. I have my hands full, Detective.
Do you? That'd be a hell of a way to ruin a good career.
Off the record, you know
suspect of all that. It was just your basic he said, she said.
So you covered his ass.
A girl with a grudge can destroy a man whether he did something or not. I have seen it happen.
Well, we are way past he said, she said, okay? We are now looking at rape murder.
He wasn't here. It was a mistake. I'm sorry.
You should be.
Go here.
Hey, I didn't go anywhere, but it reminds me of a man I wanted to go for you.
months. That's more.
Was that odd for Chuck?
Really?
Huh, just weird enough as a hangover at a time. Is that helpful?
Very helpful, Professor.
Thank you. We'll be in touch with you.
The first time we talked to the good Professor, Chuck was an angel.
Yeah, he's a slacker with a hangover.
He doesn't remember anybody who was in class until we bring him up.
Suddenly he remembers a whole lot of specifics. What do you think Russo's angle is?
I don't know, but he's definitely covering up for something. The guy keeps feeding us what we want to hear.
Which version of Chuck do you believe? Star student or slacker?
Let's see what the suspect's sperm count is. I think we'll have a better idea.
Yeah, it looks like we got two healthy boys on our hands. Cook and Rosie's little swimmers are ship shape.
Okay.
Yeah. Remember when, John?
I see the same thing to you, man.
So Cougar and Mosley free to go?
Well, Cougar, yeah. We got no real reason to hold him.
Right, but Mosley?
He was straight with us from the beginning about his relationship with Gene, so until we can confirm his alibi about where he was from midnight till class the next morning, I see we can't.
His mother is on the way in.
He was home by one. He had to be here to class the next morning.
Does he have a curfew?
Yes, he does. I have always insisted that academics come first. And when his work is done, and only when it's done, can he participate in extracurricular activities.
You consider big-time college basketball an extracurricular activity? Are you serious?
My son has the potential to be much more than a basketball player.
Your son is one of the best kids in the paint in the country. He went pro. He can make more money in 1 week than everybody in this building combined. Nothing we could do to Mosley could compare to the wrath of this one.
We got no sperm. His alibi is good. Let him go.
Rousseau's class started out at first as a seminar on French lit. Great. Les mis for all. A few weeks in, Rousseau's eyeing Jean.
Eyeing out.
You know, moody and sensitive. But she wasn't into it. Did you tell her? What, don't look at me? He wasn't leering, he was just... Well, there's no law against looking, is there?
There is against stalking.
I know. She told me that every time she went into the library, he'd be there. The bookstore, same thing. Just he'd claim he was an avid reader, am I right? Exactly. I mean, the guy's a tenured professor. They have to kill somebody to lose their job.
But these situations often come down to the student's word against that of a well-liked professor.
Well, sir, Ms. Gallagher is not speaking much these days.
I've had several discussions with Henry, and we've agreed that he will modify his behavior accordingly.
In our world, behavior modification means prison time.
For unwanted attention, please.
Again, sir, we call it stalking. Legally harassment, too. If we find priors, it goes up to menacing in the first degree.
Menacing? Well, that's in the eye of the beholder, isn't it?
No, Father. It's in the eye of the district attorney.
And then in 1976, Rousseau was accused of forcing himself on a Sarah Lawrence girl during a bicentennial tequila bash. She passed out and then came to in his frat house on the receiving end of a forcible oral cock.
And?
Well, the girl was given cab fare to Bronxville while Rousseau's fraternity became known as I Ate a Pie. That's when the good fathers at St. Raymond's took him on as a teaching assistant. Since then, the guy's racked up quite a string of babies.
It's like a timeline in the history of sex crime legislation. What did they call it before we invented the terms date rape and sexual harassment?
Boys will be boys.
I need arrest models.
I just say the magic word, Counselor.
I need physical evidence on murder.
Well, we canvass the crime scene.
To do that, maybe we'll search his home office.
I think I'm falling in love with you, Abby.
Wait a minute.
What?
I'd like to see people take a little breather before they let the healing begin. Enrolled in God's college now. I love you, Gene.
Oh, come on. It's a spontaneous outpouring of emotion by the students.
All I'm saying is, if I die, from the spot where I go down, you better make sure that this never happens to me. I don't want to hurt you the rest of your days.
Noted. Okay, so where's Rousseau's office?
That way. Where do you walk by this way every day to get those lecture halls?
Familiarity.
We got reddish fragments of the wound, right?
We never found the murder weapon, the rock or brick or whatever.
Maybe it's a building.
A building?
Yeah, you know he pushes her around? Take the attacker.
Attacker? Someone. The bastards are hitting the wall like that? Oh, no, no, no. You meant here over the head with the building. Gotcha.
Except the body was found over there. We got no drag marks leading from that body. Forensics went over that area, but it's
Wait up. Stairs.
Yeah.
What if he pushed her? What if he pushes her down the stairs? This whole time we've been assuming that the rock hit her.
Maybe she hit the rock. Any notes he sent to Dean or comments he may have written on her papers that weren't about, structure, theme.
I handle the papers and the green.
Any conferences scheduled for after office hours?
He's so scheduled. Becky, listen to me. We're not here to bust you for padding his grade book. Rousseau had his favorites, all teachers do. But in this case, if you don't help us, there's going to be another Jeep down with her. That's his schedule.
Yes, it is. Political science at 10:20, lunch at the Sprout Factory. 165th to Reservoir, what's that mean?
That's a jogging path.
You joking?
No.
What's he doing in a political science class?
It's not him. It's her. This is Jean's schedule. His schedule was her schedule. Where is he now? His class in 20 minutes and he's gone. He's been trying since I'm a pusher.
I know there's all. Revenant de chasse. Tout le monde, les airs obscurs, les agates.
Flowers of evil. How appropriate.
Very good. Unfortunately, I'm in the middle of a lecture. But perhaps we can exchange more valuable more after class. Why don't you let her rip now? Class is dismissed.
Henry Rousseau, you are under arrest for the rape and murder of Jean Gallagher.
Roll up your sleeve, please.
Oh, I'm sorry, what?
Could you roll up your sleeve, please?
It's kind of like a bad French film noir, isn't it? All these cops around in a circle, some silent. Some leaning in with cynical blips.
Sort of.
This is what you did to Jean Gallagher. Raping her, throwing her down the steps to shut her up.
That's not it. Well, then, enlighten us, please.
I'm gonna rape her.
You raped her, then you pushed her. Her head hit the stone steps. Your semen sample's back at the lab, awaiting your blood. And when they match, you're gonna stand trial for rape homicide.
Come on, miss, you're badgering my client.
It's detective, not miss. And we're not in court, counselor. We're in my house. Why don't you save your lawyer for somebody who gives a damn?
I didn't kill her.
You panicked. You thought if you could just drag her body into the bushes, no one would notice for a while. It'll give you time to clean up.
No? Or maybe you figured you'd look like a stranger who dragged her into the bushes, huh?
No. I didn't. She was already dead.
What do you mean?
How did you feel? I was watching them.
Who?
The two of them. Mostly. They were like animals. Like weasels. Then he left her. I waited somewhere. Looked through the window while she partied. My leash came out. The top step she lost her footing. The way she always left. Then she fell off her shoe.
can tell it's just that. So I carried her until I got home.